subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
See how to guess answers correctly. How to guess correctly in JEE Advanced. Okay. Trick is try to skip high and lowest values. Try to skip highest and lowest values. So now let's see what does this mean. Okay. Try to skip highest and lowest values means, for example, let's think there is question and there are four different options. First option is 40, second option is 22, third option is 66, fourth option is 82. Okay, so there is one question and four options are given for that question, and the values are option A 40, option B 22, option C 66, option D 82. Okay, and you don't know the answer for this. After solving this question, you are unable to get the correct answer. So now what you need to do is, so here is the technique. Out of four values, try to skip highest value and lowest value. See, out of all the four elements, out of all the four options, try to remove highest value and lowest value. Highest value means 82. Eliminate this. Lowest value means 22. Eliminate this. Okay. So in the given options, when you are trying to guess some answer, you need to eliminate, you need to skip highest and lowest values, and then you need to select one of the options from the available options, because there will be least probability for highest and lowest values to be correct option. Okay, there will be least probability for highest and lowest values for being the correct answer. So whenever you are trying to guess something, just skip highest and lowest values. Next important technique means, if there is no negative marking, then attempt all. Okay, if there is no negative marking, then you are safe. See, coming to our JEE Advanced, few questions will be having negative marking and few questions will be not having negative marking. Okay, so whatever questions don't have negative marking, go for them. You should not even leave one question unattempted. Okay, so whatever answer you think, just put it. Okay, don't leave even one question blank. Okay, because there is no negative marking, so you should not leave them blank. Coming to units and measurements, so now let's see what is the technique you can use for units and measurements. See, for example, there is a question and they are asking, what is the expected temperature? Okay, what is the expected temperature? This is the question, and there are four options. For to this particular question, they are clearly asking what is the temperature. Okay, so temperature can't be in, so this option can be eliminated. So now we have two options left, and two options are having degrees. So like this, logically you need to think and eliminate the options which are having irrelevant units or measurements. Okay. Next cheat code is no extreme values. What does this mean? For example, let's think there is a question and there are four options. Option A is 2, option B is 4, option B is 8, option D is 21. Okay, so see, out of these four options, which is having extreme value? Extreme means different value. this is having different values, so you can't put this as answer. Okay, you have to guess only, you have to put only one of these three options as the answer. Okay, you should avoid extreme values. Okay, so next to chessy, all of the above, none of the above. Next is all of the above, none of the above. See, when you have all of the above as one of the option, you can go for it. You have all of the above as one of the option and you don't know what is the correct answer, then there are high chances that all of the above is the correct answer. Then you can happily go for it. Okay, and if you find none of the above as one of the option and if you don't know what is the correct answer, don't go for it. Okay, there are very least probabilities of none of the above being the correct answer. Okay, so that's why always go for all of the above. Next is elimination method. So what is elimination method? When you have four options, using your logic, using the concept which you know which is related to this question, try to eliminate the irrelevant options. Okay, so then out of four options, after eliminating the irrelevant options, you will be left with only two options. Then you can happily guess and put one of these options. Okay, this is called elimination method. Using your logic and your common sense and the concept which you know related to the question, just eliminate irrelevant options. Okay, for giving best videos for you people, me and my team is working so much hard for you people. So yeah, please support us. Subscribe and hit the bell icon, and also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end, and all the very best to your exam. Thanks for watching.